Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Sideboard, the Las Vegas Open Series featuring the Invitational. I'm Glenn Jones, and I'm joined in the booth by Brian Kibler.
Hello, hello.
You're playing a color familiar to you and to your fans. You're playing green.
I am.
You're actually playing like a Golgari mid-range deck that seems kind of similar to the Jund deck we saw Matt Costa take and open with, but you've got rid of the red, and you're just running all the green-black goodies, basically.
Yeah. I eventually got to this. I got to this deck because the green-black aggro deck, the Golgari aggro deck that I had been playing for a while, just wasn't really doing it for me anymore.
Sure.
One of the problems with a deck like that is that in a field like this where there's a bunch of removal and the sort of mix of cards you need to play in a deck like that, you can have just hands that don't really work together. You know, you end up having a hand of, you know, a bunch of removal spells and a Thoughtseize against, you know, a control deck, which is pretty terrible because you can't apply pressure.
Right, and they just eventually get ahead of you.
Right, you know, your cards all individually aren't high enough impact. And the format has moved toward a lot of decks where that's important. You know, you can't really afford to, a lot of your cards just aren't really high impact enough in a lot of matchups. Against like Blue Devotion, you really need your removal spells, but against, you know, the control decks, those removal spells are really bad. And you can't make up for it with individual card power because the majority of your cards are fairly weak. You have cards that are on their own aren't really that high impact.
That's a pretty common problem when you have to fight, especially high synergy decks like Mono Blue Devotion, when they're accessing Master Waves. It's like when you brick, you're actually just going to die like a lot of the time.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was moving the deck around in a number of ways to give it sort of more flexibility in terms of what the threats were doing. And I realized that the best card in my deck in so many matchups was just Polukranos.
Sure.
And I was just, why don't I build a deck that is better, you know, better structured around Polukranos? And, you know, I had the problem of, against red decks, you know, a lot of my small creatures weren't really good enough to defend me, and they'd kill my mana creatures, and Polukranos wouldn't be able to come online. And I realized, I was like, okay, well, I just want to try playing with Sylvan Caryatid. And Sylvan Caryatid does so much to give the deck additional stability in a lot of matchups. Not only is it a mana accelerant, but it's also a mana fixer. A big problem with the green-black aggro deck, too, was your mana's just not that good. You know, and that's a big, big problem for a deck that needs to be applying pressure early. If you're missing a color and your hand is Dreg Mangler or Left Troll, you're dead. You can't do anything. So, you know, the mana in Standard right now can't really support multicolor aggressive decks very well unless they're basically single color splash. And you can't be a single color splash deck if the best cards in your deck are stuff like Left Troll and Dreg Mangler.
Yeah, the more multicolored cards you have, the earlier you need that stuff.
Right, so, you know, you can't really play four Guildgates in an aggressive deck because you stumble and you need to be able to apply in that pressure. So I was like, okay, well, I want to make my deck more mid-range, let myself actually play four copies of Guildgate, and rely on Sylvan Caryatid for additional acceleration and mana fixing.
Okay, well, that's exactly what you've done, and in addition to Polukranos, you're packing Reaper of the Wilds, a card that's growing in popularity. Very good against the decks that are just leaning on removal. It's only really removable by, like, Verdict or Elspeth at this point.
That was a card that was also in the aggressive deck, and it is so much better in this deck than it was in that one. Like, leaps and bounds better. In the aggressive deck, because you were using it as sort of the top of your curve, you frequently just have to tap out to play it.
Yeah, just jam
it. Get killed, it doesn't really matter. The fact that it's, you know, has a lot of durability is excellent sometimes, but a lot of times your creature just wasn't having, you know, isn't high impact enough. Against, for instance, the mono blue devotion decks, you know, they can just have a Master of Waves and you're dead because, you know, this guy just didn't do enough. I actually, in my very original version of this deck, it was Desecration even Polukranos, because I hadn't been super happy with Reaper in the green-black deck for a while. But then Desecration Demon in this sort of deck just wasn't meshing with what I wanted to do. I went back to Reaper, and it's been an all-star, because every part of its abilities are really relevant. The Scry ability in particular is so much better in a mid-range control style deck, where you have individually higher powered cards you can scry for.
Yeah.
When you're playing, you know, green-black aggro, it's like, okay, I scry, it's like, oh, well, it's another Lotlith Troll, it's turn 8. I don't really want this, but, you know, but whereas here, it's like, okay, I'm looking for one of my big impact cards, and I can dig for it. And this deck also just gets to play a whole bunch more removal, so it gets a whole bunch more scry.
So, you can actually scry on purpose a lot.
Right.
All right. Moving up, you've got Thoughtseize, marquee black card. We won't be seeing black decks without that card for quite some time in Standard, of course.
Yep.
And a big fan of Thoughtseize, Brian Gilbert.
I mean, people say, they're like, oh, you hate Thoughtseize, you're playing with Thoughtseize. It's like, I hate Thoughtseize because of what it does to games of Magic. I like playing with it because it's powerful, but I don't enjoy what it does to the way that games play out and, you know, how it invalidates card text and such. So.
Yep. Then you have Read the Bones, which when people are playing cards like Thoughtseize specifically, going into these attrition-y decks, like the black decks, they use Underworld Connections to get ahead. You're not running that. You're running Read the Bones, and obviously against any control deck, the Esper and the Blue-Eyed decks, this is also just a nice card to have. They run Divination. You can kind of match them, even overpower them, since it's a slightly better spell.
Right. Well, what I was talking about with Reaper, Scry, is just a powerful effect in a deck like this. And in particular, one of the problems that a lot of mid-range decks often have, just sort of structurally, is that they are decks that have cards that are very powerful in specific matchups and not great in others. And Scry is so good in a deck like that because you can, you know, it's like, okay, I'm playing against control, removal spell on top, those are going to the bottom.
Yeah.
I'm playing against an aggro deck, it's like, oh, another Thoughtseize, I don't want that, another Read the Bones, I don't have time for that, those go to the bottom. So it's not just raw card count, but the fact that it's giving you a lot of flexibility and control over your draws in a deck type where that's very important makes it really, really good in this deck.
Yeah, the filtering element's very good. We've even seen that to some extent in the Mono Blue Devotion deck with Thassa, when that deck just needs to combo together so many actual spells, the Scry becomes really relevant. In this deck, comboing specific spells, very important.
Absolutely.
Among those specific spells, we've mentioned removal. You've got Abrupt Decay and Hero's Downfall. I think this is a great weekend for Abrupt Decay, coming right off of Grand Prix where Detention Sphere was just an all-star, and Abrupt Decay is just an awesome spell against any Detention Sphere laden deck.
It's great. It's your best removal spell against almost every card in Mono Blue Devotion.
Yeah.
It's only Master of Waves, Biden, and Thassa, and Jace, I guess. But all of their sort of important things that set them up, Abrupt Decay takes care of.
Yeah.
A lot of people, you know, are playing cards like Last Breath because Last Breath kills Night Vale Spectre, which is a prominent card in a number of popular decks.
Mm-hmm.
Abrupt Decay does that and also kills Detention Sphere.
Yeah.
The fact that the control decks can't rely on Detention Sphere to deal with your major threats is a huge, huge deal.
Yeah, they're very reliant on it right now. And Abrupt Decay, you know, Last Breath is not a fantastic spell. It's doing the job right now for blue-white control, but Abrupt Decay is like just actually a very good spell. You know,
right.
It's just played multiple formats.
I played against multiple blue-white control players in this tournament who had Last Breaths that were just stranded in their hand because my deck is all giant monsters.
Yeah.
You know, I was able to set up times when they wouldn't be able to use it on my Mutavaults, and you know, or my scavenging users, I could eat something in response. So, you know, they have a card that's very narrow to do a specific purpose, and I'm able to exploit that. Whereas Abrupt Decay, your deck has something that Abrupt Decay kills in it.
In addition to those two spells, which you've got several of, you're also running a split on three other spells, all of which have their uses and timings. Putrefy, pretty versatile. Ultimate Price kills a lot of things, misses some of the important ones. That's one of the struggles. Night Vale Spectre is kind of wrenched onto the format. And then you've also got a single Golgari Charm, which can handle a lot of strange problems like the enchantments we've already discussed, but it's also basically like a main deck shrivel against those white decks.
Golgari Charm is fantastic. It's actually one of the big reasons to play green-black right now, I think. That and Abrupt Decay, I think, are huge incentives to play green-black.
Sure.
Golgari Charm is... I actually had Golgari Charm, again, in the green-black aggro deck in the sideboard, and it's so much better in this deck, much like, you know, a number of things.
Yeah.
You know, there's a ton of cards that were okay in that version that are so much better here because of context. Golgari Charm is one of those, because every mode in Golgari Charm is very relevant.
Sure.
And the -1/-1 ability is far better when your deck doesn't have Elvish Mystic and Lotlith Troll and various things you can kill of your own. It's frequently Plague Wind against the white aggressive decks.
Yeah.
It kills Master of Waves, it kills Judge's Familiar, it frequently kills Cloudfin Raptures that haven't evolved yet. You know, it just does a ton of stuff, and in addition, regenerates your creatures from Supreme Verdict and then kills your opponent.
Yeah, one of the most frustrating things for me playing against the white deck with Shrivels was now that Alice V and Ben S and all these guys started playing Spear, I just have these Shrivels and they play Spear, and I'd be like, no!
It answers everything.
And Charm just...
Yeah, it answers everything that they have that you have trouble with. You know, Golgari Charm is excellent against those. It kills Biden of Thassa.
Yeah.
You know, a bunch of extremely valuable things. It's one of the best cards in your deck against the control decks.
Sure.
I was a little hesitant to play this deck coming into the weekend because of the rise of, you know, the control decks last weekend. Blue White Control, really popular deck coming out of Grand Prix Vienna and into the Grand Prix in Dallas, which I didn't quite make it to.
You and several others.
Yeah, I'd been working on this deck for a while and I really liked it. Then Blue White Control was really popular and I was like, maybe this isn't great. But you between cards like Abrupt Decay and Golgari Charm and Thoughtseize and everything, you actually can assemble a bunch of things, despite your deck looking really clunky and bad against control, that work really well against them. And Golgari Charm is a huge central piece of that.
Especially in game ones when you can exploit like that they have some bricks, and you have bricks as well, you can kind of scry through yours, but Abrupt Decay and Golgari Charm are setting them up for some blowouts.
Right.
And last but not least, another card that can really blow out those
control
decks.
Not least at all.
Vraska. You're playing three copies of Vraska. Let's get the traders on the phone.
Yeah, get ready.
Stocks going up.
I think it was $6 or something when I got them.
All right, as of filming, you heard it here. We'll see if by the time this even goes up, it's changed.
Vraska is fantastic. I was actually, a big part of what I was trying to do structurally with the deck mm-hmm. was position it such that I was able to sideboard out the majority of my big green creatures against decks sure. that might have Life Banes on. But I wanted to have, it was difficult for me to find big, good win conditions. Because I guess like Mono Black, for instance, boarding in black creatures when they're boarding in Abrupt Decay, or not Abrupt Decay, Life Bane Zombie and Dark Betrayal. Is really awkward because you know they have all these efficient ways to deal with the possible big things you have,
right, they're already
but not Vraska.
Yeah.
And Vraska gives you just incredible sort of kind of inevitability in a lot of matchups where you know you're playing sort of an attrition game, and Vraska gives you this endless source of vindicates if they don't remove it, and can actually just win the game on its own.
Yeah,
like Vraska, and particularly Vraska combined with Golgari Charm against control decks, it's like ultimate Vraska. They're like, okay, Supreme Verdict, regenerate my guys, kill you. It happens a lot, like more than you'd think. And you know it kills Elspeths, it kills Desecration Demons, it kills Underworld Connections. All these things, which are sort of creature types that it's difficult to play reactive yeah. cards against, in addition to threatening to win the game by itself.
I know when Vraska first came out, many, including myself, panned it heavily because it felt like you could just ignore it mm-hmm. and play Magic. But now that we've gotten into this like Theros metagame, the format's so slow, everyone is really attrition-y, you eventually have to pay
right.
attention.
And it's not only is the format kind of slow, there's not that many haste creatures to mm-hmm. threaten it if you play it and kill something immediately, but you have a lot of tools to actually protect it. The combination of Thoughtseize and Golgari Charm, as I mentioned before, yeah. makes its ultimate very threatening. Your opponent can't just sit there and ignore it. It's like, okay, I'll ultimate, well, I'll kill it. It's like, okay, I will Thoughtseize you, take your Supreme Verdict, ultimate. They're like, well, I had another Supreme Verdict, Golgari Charm, kill you.
Yeah.
You can set up such, you know, I've beaten Blood Barons very easily by ultimating Vraska. My opponent's at 32. I'm just like, doesn't matter, you're dead.
Assassin you. All right, yeah, I really like it, and it does really make a lot of sense. In this deck, it seems like it functions almost as a Jace, not with the negative providing card advantage, but instead mm-hmm. killing things and still sitting on the board to really affect your opponent's ability
right.
to grind you.
It provides you with a proactive answer card, mm-hmm. which is one of the most important things to have in a kind of deck like this. When you're playing a mid-range deck, one of the most important things is having cards that can sort of play both ways.
Yeah.
That can allow you to help survive the early turns against aggressive decks, and that can also, well, Vraska's not going to do that, but provide you with tools to survive against
kill
aggressive decks.
Kill what's killing you
exactly.
or kill the opponent.
To stop what's killing you or to kill your opponent. And Vraska is an example of a card that does exactly that.
All right. Well, Brian, the Invitational is well underway at this point. Your standard rounds are almost over for today. Good luck for the last one and for the remainder of Legacy and the remainder of the tournament. Thanks
Thank
for joining
you very
me.
Much.